Hello, this is Celia from ST Math, and I'm pleased to offer this mini webinar. During this crisis, you might find yourself at home trying to support your students in ST Math. So today, I'll share some strategies on how you might use ST Math to teach remotely. If your district doesn't already have an online tool for collaborating with your students, maybe something like Google Classroom or Zoom, and if it's appropriate for you to do so on your own, you can find programs to connect with your kids online. For example, right now, Cisco WebEx will provide free accounts for teachers and students. You just need to go on their website and sign up. There are a lot of others out there, though, who are offering free accounts, so you might want to ask around to find out what other teachers in your district are using. Some of your students are going to want to solve ST math puzzles all day long. It's really fun for kids, and families know that it's a good instructional program. So they might think it's okay to play for hours and hours. And although we love that our parents and families and students love ST Math, there are some recommended usage times depending upon the grade level. You can see on this slide how much time we suggest is appropriate, and we encourage students just to play in 20 or 30 more minute sessions to reach their weekly goal. Remember that ST Math is designed to supplement your current math curriculum. It's not meant to replace it. Then, as you teach from afar, one idea you can use to help make learning really meaningful is to reorder the objectives in ST Math so that they match the sequence you might teach if your kids were in front of you in the classroom. All you need to do to get there is to sign into your ST Math teacher account, and then click on the curriculum tab that's located up at the top of your screen. From there, you're going to be able to see all of the objectives that are assigned to your students, and then you just drag and drop them to reorder them in a sequence that you prefer. We demonstrated how to do this in our very first webinar, and you can search for it on YouTube by using the keywords ST Math if you'd like some additional help with this. Now, sometimes you might have a student or a family member who is reluctant to reach out to you if they need some help. But ST Math makes it really easy for you to spot those kids who might need your guidance. If you sign into your ST Math teacher account, you can click on the Alerts tab that's up at the top of the screen, and this report will inform you of any student who might need some additional help and you might want to reach out to them individually. One of the most difficult things teachers are facing right now is not being able to help their students right when they need it. So when your students get stuck and you're not able to help them right away, the GG I'm Stuck journal can be used for independent problem solving, as well as encouraging writing and some reflection. It makes it easy for you to review later with the student, and it could even lead to the student solving their own problem. Another strategy to help your students as you teach remotely is to ask thoughtful questions that help students figure out problems on their own. This cycle represents how we learn and how learning is designed in ST Math. The questions are ones that you can ask any student no matter what game they're playing. As your students are progressing through puzzles, there might be times when they do ask you for help, and you can use this cycle and these questions to help students help themselves. If you are creating presentations or you're sharing some live lessons, this could also be a great topic for you to explore with your students or to share with your parents. However, sometimes a parent or student is going to reach out to you for help with a certain puzzle because they think they can't solve it. Now, you can always ask them the questions that we just discussed to help them figure it out, but sometimes it's okay and it's appropriate. Let your kids struggle a little bit. This type of purposeful struggle is called productive struggle. It is that process of effortful learning that develops grit and it develops creative problem solving. When students face problems they don't immediately know how to solve, we don't want them to just give up. You want your students to be able to attack that problem and solve it in a way that makes sense to them. This is what encourages your kids to become independent learners, and it also deepens their understanding of math. Your reports are going to tell you which kids might really need a hand. We also have great resources that you can print, and they're available in ST Math Central. These resources can be used to teach remotely even when your students are not all on the same game. All of the resources are great for parents too, so don't hesitate to use them. You can share the facilitation tools or the scavenger hunt and math challenges. It's really important to involve families when appropriate, since we have to get through this unusual time together. And I'll share with you the web address to ST Math Central at the end of this webinar. If you have been using ST Math for a little while, you probably already have heard about puzzle talks or math chats. Puzzle talks are great ways to bring ST Math games into your students' home and leverage the power of their visual models. ST Math chats are lessons that follow a play, discuss, apply model. And each lesson has an introduction, there's a designated time for students to play a specific game, they can have a discussion, and then there's a conclusion that features an extension question, which is designed to deepen conceptual understanding by having students apply what they have just learned. If you participated in our first mini webinar, which included the interpreting data from reports section, you might remember that you can use that information to identify struggling students, but you can also choose to use this data to decide what math chats might be most appropriate and helpful to your students right now. Although both puzzle talks and math chats really are designed for classroom use, where you can have discussion really easily, we've developed separate mini webinars to help you modify them for remote learning. And you can search for those on YouTube by searching for ST Math. This is the fifth of a series of short webinars that you can join to learn a bit more about ST Math. Look for others on YouTube, or you can search for resources in ST Math Central. I also recommend doing the self-guided online courses that you can find in ST Math Central. You can complete those on your own, they're free, and you can go at your own pace.